Yes, madam, and my dear colleagues, permission from all. I am HMND Kumari. My research topic is a study on soft skills development of prospective teachers in primary education. Significance of the study. Soft skills is the very important for teachers and administrators during 21st century because soft skills have been recognized as the highly critical skills in the current global job market, especially in the fast moving era of technology. In 2014, soft skills defined as the transferable skills and 21st century skills. It's mean soft skills have become a very important skills must have every person must have. At present, soft skills for teachers is an important theme discussed in various parts. At this moment, I must say Pachu and Yadevi in 2014 a quality human capital comes from a quality education process. According to this statement, if build a quality human capital, it's parallelly institution of teacher education also must adapt or must change to make a quality human capital. But when we considering about Sri Lanka, Vijay Singha says the country has recognized the education means not just academic learning, but also the development of professional and vocational skills and the soft skills that will allow these to be used productively. This statement emphasized that soft skills must improve to professional or vocational training also. When we turn toward the pre-service teacher training, actually today there is some criticism focused on recruited teachers from NCOEs because some principals do not desire to get the recruit teachers because they have no qualities like leadership qualities, communication qualities, problem solving qualities like that. I think the reason for this, actually comparing with other countries, teacher education system in Sri Lanka doesn't focus much more attention to develop soft skills in prospective teachers. Considering above facts, it can be defined that there must be a conducting a deeper study regarding teacher educator, teacher trainees, acquisition soft skills in the procedure needed at present. According to this situation, this research may be beneficial for pre-service teacher training in Sri Lanka. These are the objectives of my research. First one, to identify opportunities provided to prospective teachers to develop soft skills through the existing curriculum. Second one, to identify the perception of teacher educators and prospective teachers in developing soft skills into the primary teacher education. Third one, to develop and implement a program which would facilitate to enhance soft skills among prospective teachers. Fourth one, to assess the level of soft skills that gained by prospective teachers from implemented program. Last one, to suggest ways and means to improve soft skills program and develop guidelines to practice in the pre-service teacher training. these are the research questions. About these research objectives and questions, I will talk about my methodology part. In the literature review, my literature review, I could identify some major themes related to my research topic. Soft skills definition and categorization, soft skills in teacher education, developing soft skills, approach to teach soft skills. In my study, I hope to develop soft skills of prospective teachers. As this reason, I had to review literature regarding what are the approaches many researchers use to develop soft skills in their research. So I could identify there are three main approaches. First one is standalone subject model. Second one, embedded model. Third one, combination of standalone subject model and embedded model. In this standalone subject model, if we need to develop soft skills, we can do a workshop or implement a program like that. In the second one, embedded model, if we need to develop soft skills, we can embed soft skills to existing curriculum. But I think as a researcher, I can't change the curriculum of embedded soft skills to an existing curriculum. As this reason, I choose standalone subject model as the suitable approach to develop soft skills for prospective teachers. Assessment of soft skills theme. Actually, somebody has a notion that we can't measure or assess soft skills and how to assess soft skills because soft skills are just like a human quality. But in this research review, I could identify many researchers assess the soft skills in their research using standardized soft skills model. So according to this explanation, you can understand we can assess the soft skills. So theoretical framework support to a researcher to mark the limitation of he or his research, and that also support to guide to do the research in correct way. So in theoretical framework regarding my research, I identify two theories. First one, the transformational learning theory proposed by Maseros in 1996. Second one, Dahlo's mentorship theory proposed by Dahlo's in 1999. According to this picture, you can see here regarding transformation learning theory, there are some mistakes. Maseros explained here, if need to change a life of somebody, he can change his or her life using life experience. So to develop soft skills prospective teachers, I think this theory is very important because it guide me how to develop soft skills by step by step. Second theory is mentorship theory. Here Danos explained this theory like this. The mentor interprets the environment and coach the learner how to function in his or she new environment. So I think these are very important and most important theories for my research. This is the conceptual framework. This may be changed because tentative one, this one. There are three contextual variables. You can see here. First one, the nature of curriculum and co-curriculum framework of National College of Education. Second one, the nature of external activities of NCOE. And third one, the nature of prospective teachers. These three contextual variables are affected to soft skills of prospective teachers. Otherwise, development, self-confidence and integrate good qualities to real life, I explained earlier, and a mentor role. These are also affected to development soft skills. In this research, I hope to use standalone model to develop soft skills of prospective teachers. So this is the conceptual framework of my research. Research methodology. Quantitative research method is based my research. There are two phrases. In the first phrase, there are two steps. I hope to identify what are the opportunities prospective teachers have to develop soft skills through their existing curriculum in NCOEs, and I hope to identify what are the perception of lecturers and prospective teachers regarding introduce soft skills development program to NCOEs. So to get the answers for two questions, I use survey research design in the first phrase. In the second phrase, I hope to get answers to third, fourth and fifth research questions. Therefore, I use experimental research design for this phrase. In the first phrase, this is the flow chart of the first phrase, reviewing curricula, primary education course and analyzing data, and step 2, selection of standardized questionnaire through literature, piloting questionnaire and getting data through sampling and analyzing data. Finally, hope to get answers first and second questions. This is the flow chart of second phrase. This is the methodology summarize of my research. First research objective is to identify opportunities provided to prospective teachers to develop soft skills through the existing curriculum. Here there are three main subject components in NCOE regarding primary education course: general subject, special subject and professional subject. So I hope to identify actually are there opportunities provided to prospective teachers to develop soft skills. The method and content analysis method used for this, and selected printed documents are used as the instruments. For data analysis, content analysis is suitable. In the for second objective, to identify the perception of teacher educators and prospective teachers on developing soft skills into pre-service teacher educate. The method is quantitative method, and survey design hope to use. As the sample, I hope to select 600 prospective teachers from 3 NCOEs who are following primary education course, and 20 teacher educators. Questionnaire and semi-structured interviews are used as the instrument. For data analysis, SPSS statistic package to find out mean value and standard deviation. Third research objective is to develop and implement program which would facilitate trainings of students and prospective teachers. I hope to implement a program to develop soft skills among prospective teachers. I hope to choose prospective teachers as two groups: target group and control group. Prospective 60 prospective teachers used for this. So workshop activities, presentation, and modules are used as the instrument for data analysis using pre-test and post-test result. Fourth research objective is my research to assess the level of soft skills that gained by prospective teachers from implemented program. Here QC experimental design I hope to use. I mentioned like earlier 60 prospective teachers have participated this assessment, and standardized questionnaire. I mentioned like earlier, I found out Cambriot's original soft skills performance measure questionnaire. I hope to utilize this questionnaire to assess the level of soft skills. For data analyzing, SPSS static package to find out value here. Paired sample t-test analysis. Last one, to suggest ways and means to improve soft skills program and develop guidelines to practice in the pre-service teacher training. According to pre-test and post-test result, I hope to suggest ways and means to improve this program to implement in teacher education. These are the limitations of my research. Only prospective teachers who are following primary course will be employed for the study, and only 3 National College of Education which conducted primary course out of 19 NCOEs will be selected. That also, the study is limited to only prospective teachers whose first language is Sinhala. For the researchers' convenience, NCOEs will be selected only from Gampa and Kurunegala district. Present status of the study. Now I have finished my literature review regarding these themes. These are the references used for my research proposal. Okay, thank you so much for everyone.